Hello everyone, I'm back at the nursery. It's a bit nippy this morning. We had a major thunderstorm roll through here last night with high winds and lots of thunder and lightning. But it doesn't seem like the great blue herons or the eagles are any worse for wear. They're going through their daily routines. The great blue heron are pretty much sitting on their eggs at this point. And the male eagle just flew in with a fish, and the mother is feeding the chick. I've been so excited about this eagle chick that I think I've neglected the great blue herons a little bit. And let's face it, they were the first inhabitants here at the nursery, and the eagles may not even be here without them because they took over a great blue heron nest and made it huge, but otherwise they may not have built their own nest here. So what I'd like to do is share some video and some pictures of what they've been up to. They're a wild bunch, let me tell you. So I hope you enjoy, and I've been having a great morning, and I hope you have a great day. The great blue herons arrive at the nursery in early to mid-March. Although they are mostly monogamous during the breeding season, they choose new partners every year, so there's a lot of courting behavior when they return. Rebuilding and showing off nests to prospective females, exchanging branches, and clapping their bills and puffing and grooming. During this courting time, their long bills turn yellow and their plumes are exaggerated with an incredible black crest on top and black eye streaks. Take a look at our rookery. It now has over 40 active breeding pairs, where 10 years ago there was just one pair. There's lots of names for the colony, including a rookery, a heronry, a battery, a hedge, a scattering, and my favorite, a posse. The nests are built of branches and lined with finer pieces of sticks and leaves. I've seen a number of herons breaking off leafed-out branches to line their nests. Once they've paired off and went out on a couple of dates to the local fish cafe, they settle into incubating their eggs. Usually the female lays between 2 to 7 blue to bluish-green eggs, and both parents help to incubate the eggs. Boy, what a boring time it is to incubate those eggs. For 25 to 30 days, they just sit, sometimes getting up to stretch or move a stick or two, then right back down onto the nest. They usually hunt alone, but I got up real early one morning and set up my bird blind in Holbert's pond, which was totally fogged in. As the morning mist burned off, to my surprise, there were 15 individuals hunting together. It was spectacular. They seemed to eat just about anything, including fish, crayfish, frogs, salamanders, snakes, dragonflies, grasshoppers, and aquatic insects. They've even been known to eat mice and small birds. They've also been known to choke on things too big for them because they swallow their food whole. I really do think that their middle name is patience. I've watched a great blue heron stand totally still for 10 minutes before it struck lightning fast for a fish. Some scientific information for you. The great blue heron is in the family of Ardeidae, which consists of 98 species of herons, bitterns, and egrets in North America. Our great blues are the biggest of all of these. Their wingspan can reach over 6 feet, even though they only weigh about 6 pounds. When they fly, it is spectacular. These babies remind me of a prehistoric pterodactyl. Maybe they are descendants of the dinosaurs. Who knows? These incredible birds were prolific until plume hunters just about wiped them out during the late 1800s and early 1900s. Then, DDT hit the remaining population, so that by 1955, they actually were very rare in Massachusetts. Thankfully, they have made a great comeback. Even with significant habitat loss, they now range from the Caribbean and Central America up into Canada, earning a coveted conservation status of least concern. Way to go, Great Blues! Some cool facts about great blue herons. They have specially built eyes that give them great night vision. Also, if you watch them closely, they seem to be always grooming. They have feathers on their chests, which continue to grow and fray. Herons will take this frayed down and move it through their feathers, almost like a washcloth, soaking up fish oils and other sludge picked up from the marshy, muddy soil. I guess they figure they have to look good for all the photographers who line up to take their pictures like paparazzis to movie stars. You gotta agree, our great blues are incredible. Just a quick reminder, please become a member of Mass Audubon. By supporting their good work, you support the ongoing conservation and education which benefits our community and our eagles and our great blues. Visit them at www.massaudubon.org.